I'm making a hot box, and the hot box will be used to cure silicone molds and resin castings. It's recommended that you post-cure such things for 150 degrees for about 4 hours. This will be installed external to the box. This is a fan. It's very similar to a computer cooling fan, except this is 110 volt. Air will come out of the box, be directed into a heater. This is a positive temperature coefficient heater, ceramic heater. What's nice about those is that they will not overheat. The hotter they get, the less power they draw. So air will be directed through the heater and will return to the box. Made my own 90 degree elbows. These are 22 and a half degree miters. If you want to know how to make this, I have a video for making the segmented section on the dust collector. There's a link below. You can watch how that's done. This is schedule 40. It's cut on the bandsaw, sanded flat on the belt sander, and just glued together with PVC cement. The fan is going to be glued in here. I have pins in here just holding it in position until I get the outside of the box made. This is a MH1210F temperature controller. Now these are readily available out of Hong Kong or China, but they're usually Celsius. And there is somebody in California who's selling this for 110 volt and it's in Fahrenheit. This wire comes over here to the temperature probe, and I have this clamp just holding this temperature probe on the exhaust side of this assembly. I plug it in. The fan is on, and this is set to go to 115 degrees. It takes a while for that 250 watt element to warm up, and we're just sucking in room temperature air and waiting for the exhaust temperature to come up. The display has slowed down because it's no longer indicating tenths of a degree. It's indicating units of degree. It's taking longer for this to heat up because we're still drawing in room temperature air. It's cooled off in the shop a little bit, so if I block the discharge on this, that'll warm up a little quicker. It's reached 115 degrees. The controller has turned off the heating element. It will not turn back on again until we get down to 114 degrees. When it gets to 114 degrees, the controller turns the heater back on, but the heating element has cooled off, so it will continue to drop in temperature until the element has a chance to recuperate. It's back up to 115, it's turned off the heating element, and the cycle repeats. When this is mounted onto the hot box, I believe this will be able to maintain 150 degrees fairly easy. The hot box was made with this 1/4 inch plywood. It's used for flooring. It's usually cupped and bowed. So to make it flat, I cut 1 inch strips of 1/2 inch Baltic birch, glued it and stapled it around the perimeter of each side, then screwed the sides together with drywall screws, put another border of 1/2 inch ply to make this a total of 1 inch thick, so I would have room for 1 inch of styrofoam. And then I just used the table saw to cut away a 1/2 thickness. So that will go in here and be flush. And on the outside, there'll be a piece of this 1/8 inch plywood, and that will just get glued and stapled around the perimeter. And the job for this plywood is just to protect the styrofoam. That styrofoam is so easily damaged. The hot box is 14 inches wide, 22 inches long, and 17 inches deep on the inside. It's 1 3/8 inches thick. There's 1/4 inch plywood on the inside, 1 inch of styrofoam insulation, and a 1/8 inch plywood cover on the outside. This is large enough to put a pressure pot on the inside. It's large enough to put 2 pressure pots on the inside if I choose to do so. And you have enough airspace around the outside for heat distribution when you're blowing the hot air in there. I haven't made the top for this hot box yet. I've just put a piece of cardboard on here, and I've taken my heating assembly I've got two holes cut in the cardboard. A temperature probe is stuck down in, about halfway down inside the box. I'm just going to turn this on, and I've got this set for 150 degrees. I'm going to see about how long it takes to come up to temperature with a not very good lid. So it's taken 26 minutes for this to go from room temperature to 150 degrees. When it got to 150 degrees, it turned off the heating element. It cooled back down to 149. And again, we're waiting for the heating element to recover, bring the temperature back up to 150, which shouldn't take very long. So this is working fine. The cardboard's a pretty good insulator. This is fairly hot, and the return side is fairly hot. The problem is the motor. You can hear that motor's making noise, and it doesn't have much run time on it. I played with this the other day. The temperature of this motor climbed to over 230 degrees. That motor is not going to survive. I'm going to forget about this particular heating assembly. I've ordered another heating element so I can run two heating elements on the initial heat up. And then I will turn one of those off to maintain temperature. And I'm going to use a squirrel cage blower over here, which will get the motor outside of the airstream. I was hoping this would work, but that cooling fan motor is not very happy. I've had the motor running by itself for about 10 minutes. Temperature varies between 138 and 144. This has taken about a half an hour to get it to 170 degrees. And I think we've reached a point of equilibrium between the heat loss out of the top of this cardboard and the heat that we're putting in. These ceramic elements, as they get hotter, the amperage drops on them. In order to get more heat out of one of these, you need to blow more air through them. This computer type cooling fan is rated at 60 CFM. That's 60 CFM if it's blowing in open air. We've got that throttled down quite a bit here. I doubt if we're even getting 20 CFM through that heating element. So with a squirrel cage blower, and we keep the air moving across that, we'll get more heat out of the element, and with the second element, be able to raise the temperature a lot faster. I used an inch and a half wide piece of half inch ply to go all the way around the box, and that sits right on top of the box. And there's a 1-inch piece that's glued to that that overlaps inside a half an inch, and a 2-inch piece over here which comes up an inch above and gives me a half inch overlap on the outside. And I've created a cap. Your heat has to try to escape by going up and back down again. I don't anticipate using a seal on there, I'm just making a cap. There'll be plywood on the inside. That gives me a 1-inch thickness of styrofoam insulation here, plus another inch up here, and it'll be a plywood top. Then there'll be penetrations here for the blower, intake, and the heat going into the box. The lid has been completed. I still have to take this apart to do the penetrations. It fits on this way. There's no slop in that. It doesn't rattle around. It's a nice, snug fit. Or it'll fit that way.